Let's first get started using the so-called virtual mode to put data into the tree view. The name virtual mode comes from another tree view component, which is the virtual tree view component. The virtual tree view has been a control that's been around in the Delphi world for a long time. And the key fact is, and this is something that Apple, for example, picked up for the implementation of their views on the iPhone, you need to know how many items you want to show when the tree view is shown for the first time. That might sound ridiculous at first, and that's actually the biggest restriction. So you have a fixed data set. You can't offer dynamics as soon as you use the virtual mode, because the virtual mode works in a way that events on your tree view are being called. For example, the first event that's going to get called is, how many nodes do I need to display on the first level? And then one event is triggered for every one of those nodes, what the text is going to be for every column in the tree view. So just listening to this makes it very clear that you can't iterate all the values or something like that. What makes this so useful is that the tree view asks for the information at the time that it's needed, and that makes it very performant. So you can display huge data structures this way. However, you need to have all the data at the time of the showing of the data. It can't be flexible. There are some tricks that you can use, for example, if you group by certain values and then as soon as the next level is being expanded, that you then have yet again the chance to determine the number of items that you're showing. But it's not like the other collection-based approach where you can add and delete as you wish. Of course, you can handle some kind of dynamic with the virtual mode, but that would require you to repaint or to basically clear out all the nodes and start from scratch, because yet again, the events will ask, how many nodes am I supposed to display? You hand the number, and then for each of that nodes, you have to specify text, icons, formatting, etc. So let me show it in code. Going back to the example that we created previously, we are going to use the virtual mode to populate it with data. I'll resize the object inspector so you can better see all the events that we have. We select the tree view, and there's plenty of events, of course, and that might be overwhelming at first. However, the ones we have to focus on are the ones that start with onGet. You note one that's called OnGetNumberOfNodes. That's exactly the event that asks you, how many nodes am I supposed to display on the first level, second level, and so on. And then you have the event OnGetNodeText. And these are the two basic events that you have to implement in order to make it, well, as a tree view that actually is showing something. And of course, you can go on by saying, okay, I want to specify the text color, I want to specify the selected color, I want to specify an icon for the node. So you can basically start with very little, and then you can expand your tree view, which is another big, big advantage of the virtual approach. You can start with something easy and little, and then you can go from there. So let's implement this tree view, and this is the downside of the version that has default values already in there. You need to clear those out, because if we start this application, we actually have those values also showing at runtime. So these are not just default values for the design time. Before we start, let's rename the tree view to tree, and the form, I'll rename that to form main. That's something I always do. And when the form is shown, I want to basically start building the tree view, and I call build tree view as my method. You can name it anything you want, of course. Here we go. And the first thing we need to do, we need to delete all the nodes and all the columns. And this is where it gets tricky. One time, for two times, if you haven't dealt with a tree view before. So you say tree is our tree view. And if you hit the period, you get code completion. And there's a method called tree.clear. But you also have clear columns, clear nodes, and clear node list. So if you call clear, it clears all the columns and the nodes. You should just call tree.nodes clear, you just clear the nodes. If you just call tree.columns.clear, you just clear the columns, or you have the helper methods directly on the TreeView instance, which allows you to clear columns and clear nodes here. So what I'm going to do, because I want to really start from scratch, I'm going to call tree.clear. If we start that, we get an empty tree view. So let's add some columns. How do we do that? Tree.columns dot add, very similar to the list view from the VCL. If we call add, we get an instance of a tree view column, which we then can further customize. Or if you just want to specify the text, like I want to do right now, we simply say text column one. And we do the same thing, very dirty, column two. We do not create a memory leak here because the column is obviously also added to the tree view. So if we run this, we end up with a tree view with one, two columns. As explained previously, the default setting is that both columns are stretched and you can't resize them. Of course, this is all customizable. Let's add two more columns to make it a little bit more fun. Column four, that's it. So how do we add the data using the virtual approach? We go to the events of the tree view. So we go to events and select the event that starts with onGet. So possibly a good thing to do is to type onGet in the filter. And then you go from there with number of nodes, OnGetNumberOfNodes. And this event is supposed to return the number of nodes on a certain level in the variable a number of nodes. You see, this is passed in as reference. So going from here, how do you know where you are in the tree right now? Because you start from scratch, right? So this is what the a node property helps you with. This is basically your reference point. And if a node dot level is equal to minus one, it means you don't have any parent or anything. It's a node on the on basically where you start off on the root level. So if a node level equals minus one, then begin a number of nodes equals, let's say, 10. Let's see what happens. We end up with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 nodes on the first level. You see everything works, but we don't have any text, right? So let's define the text, and you might have figured it. We use onGet node, and we have onGet node a lot of stuff. It's loose. Let's use onGet node text. And here the same deal. The only difference is instead of an integer, we return a text, which is the text for the node. And what we get as a reference point, we get like the column and we get the mode that the tree view is currently in for the text, like selected, not selected, and so on. We're going to ignore this. Also, of course, we get the node that we have to pass the stuff in for. The key here is, a node has two very important properties. One is the index, which identifies the position of the node, and of course the level again. So let's do exactly that. Assign the level and the index to the text of the node. We don't need any condition or anything. We simply say a text equals format. And what we're going to do is the level colon and the index. So here we're going to use a node dot level, a node dot index. Let's start this. You see we have level zero for all the columns. Here you see every column contains the same value because we didn't distinguish by the column. Let's also add the column by saying, by inserting another integer, a column, and run this again. And now we should see different values for the column. You see 0, 0, 1, 0. So the columns actually start counting at 0, 1, 2, 3. And of course, the index is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So there's only one thing missing. We need to actually add some children to a node. Where do we do that? Of course, we have to go to the tree get number of nodes again. Let's say the level isn't minus one. Let's say if a node.level equals zero. That means we're going to hand the method the number of nodes that are going to be children. And here we're going to say a number of nodes equals three, for example. So every node on the root level will have three children. And let me expand this a little bit. Here you see we have first level. We can expand it now. And here you see level one, no longer level zero. And yet again, we get like the same kind of counting, 0, 1, 2. Every column has 0, 1, 2 as the index of the nodes, but the column is being counted the same way. And of course the level is also according if it's like the root, which would mean it's zero, or child, which makes it one. FNC TreeView actually offers one more value that makes it very easy to find nodes. That is something special that I haven't seen with any other tree view control. You have a node.row and a node.index we keep. And there you go. This allows you to actually address the nodes from top to bottom. So you see the row 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 doesn't pay any attention to the level or if it's a child or not. Basically, this is row 0, and at the bottom we have row 40 with index 39. And this is what makes this component so powerful, but you also see this is only possible because you specify the number of nodes on every level at basically right from the start before the values are being supplied for these numbers. So you see the advantage to specify all the total numbers and the text right from the start without having some kind of flexibility gives the advantage of big performance and also the ability being able to address every node with a row number. Let's implement one more event for the node display. Let's say you want to change the text color. And again, you can say if a node.level equals one, because we only want the nodes that show actual data, not the root nodes in our little example. And we only want to display column number three, meaning we specify the two as its index and the color, a text color, and we can use the VCL versions in this case. You're going to say CL red. Let's see. You see nothing happens on the root level, but as soon as we expand, column three has red colors. So that was already the example for the virtual mode. You have learned how to present data using the fixed data mode.